Good morning, students. Welcome to the Social Science online class. Today we are going to see Term 2, History, Unit 2, The Mughal Empire. In this lesson, we are going to trace the foundation and establishment of Mughal Empire in India. Kings of Mughal Empires. Their names are Babur, Humayun, Akbar, Jahangir, Shah Jahan, Aurangzeb. Let's see the introduction. A new empire began in India with the arrival of the Mughal king Babur. So the Mughal empire start with a king named Babur. Okay. The first king of Mughal empire is Babur. The Mughal rule lasted from AD Common Era 1526 to 1707. Next, we'll see the ancestry of Babur. Babur was the great grandson of Timur on his father's side, and his mother's side, his great grandfather was distant of Genghis Khan. So on his father's side Timur, and mother's side his grandfather was distant of Genghis Khan. Okay, now we'll see how Babur came to India. So that's why the Mughal Empire started. So we'll see foundation of the Mughal Empire. Dilwar Khan and Alam Khan arrived in Kabul. Kabul is a place where Babur is ruled. So these two empire arrived in Kabul to seek Babur's help in removing Ibrahim Lodi from power. So these two empire want to remove Ibrahim Lodi. So he asked the help to these two empires are asked the help to Babur. Okay, so Babur defeated Ibrahim Lodi in the famous battle of Panipat in 1526. This is the first Panipat. Panipat is a place. Battle of Panipat. This is the first battle of Panipat. Totally three battles happened in that place. So this is the first and famous battle. Okay, and occupied Delhi and Agra. Babur captured Delhi and Agra. Following Babur's victory in this battle, Mughal dynasty come to be established in India with Agra as its capital. So after the victory of this Panipat, their capital is Agra. In India, their capital, their Mughal dynasty capital is Agra. Next, we'll see the Babur's military conquests. After that, Babur defeated many empires. So we'll see that Babur defeated Rana Sanga and his allies at Kanwa in 1526. Okay, and next he won the war against the chief of Chanderi in 1526. Next, Babur died in 1530, and Babur was a great scholar. Okay, he knows Turkish and Persian languages, and he recorded his impressions about Hindustan, his autobiography. So he only write that Dusuki Babri. Okay, he wrote everything like his history and his successes and his conquests about he defeated empire details. Everything he only write it. That is called autobiography. He recorded his impressions about Hindustan, his autobiography. That is Dusuki Babri. This is a very famous literature. So here is a picture of Rana Sanga. Babur defeated, right? The battle of Kanwa in 1527. Our next ruler is Humayun. Sher Shah was the ruler of Bihar and Bengal. Sher Shah defeated Humayun at Chausa 1539 and Kannauj 1540. So two battles happened between Sher Shah Sur and Humayun. So Sher Shah Sur got the victory in that battle. So Humayun was defeated and overthrown, had to flee to Iran. So Humayun have no power to defeat Sher Shah Sur. So he had to flee to Iran. Flee means so overthrown to another state or another country. Okay. And after that, with the help of Persian ruler Shah Tahmasp of the Safavid dynasty, again he recaptured Delhi in 1555. Humayun recaptured with the help of Persian ruler Shah Tahmasp of the Safavid dynasty. Okay. And within the 1 year he died when he fell down the stairs of his library in Delhi. Okay. So this is the Humayun tomb in Tamil, Kallarai. Okay. This is the structure or building of the monument of Humayun. We'll see Sher Shah information. He's got victory, right? So victory in the battle of Humayun. We'll see. He also introduced lot of administration things. We'll see that Sher Shah was the son of the Afghan noble Hasan Zuri, ruler of Sasaram in Bihar. Okay. After defeating Humayun, Sher Shah started the rule of Sat dynasty at Agra. Then after the victory, he started his Sat dynasty at Agra, and then he only introduced an land revenue system. So land tax system he only introduced, and he built many roads and standardized coins, weights and measures. So he only gave the feet, differences feet and inches, right? Inches for the max, you understand that inch and feet. So he only standardized the coins, weights and measures. Okay. Next empire is Akbar. Akbar was crowned as the king when he was 14 years. At his very young age, he got the king power. So he was only 14 years. Okay. So his ruling period time 1556 to 1605. So Humayun trusted General Bairam Khan became the regent and ruled on behalf of Akbar. So he was only 14 years, right? So Bairam Khan was the representative of Akbar. Bairam Khan defeated and killed Khemu in the battle at Panipat. That is the second battle of Panipat. Okay. 1556. He captured Agra and Delhi. And Akbar assumed full control of the government. Akbar brought most of the India under his control through conquest and alliances. So Akbar battled many war and he got many victories. So Akbar got many victories and many areas he captured. So he's got Kabul, Kashmir, Lahore, Gandhar, Multan, Panipat, Delhi, Agra, Lucknow, Allahabad, Bihar, and Patna, Bengal, Odisha, Malwa, Gandhis, Gujarat, Ajmer. So he got many places. He defeated many empires and he got many victories. Akbar died in 1605 and his mortal remains were buried at Sikandra near Agra. Okay. So this is the tomb of Akbar. Okay.